You grab your phone, open up Instagram as usual, go to your profile only to see this. Yep, I too was upset about the covers looking all wrong, the name and bio being decentered, the whole thing looking unbalanced and no longer aesthetic. Luckily, there's a lot that you can do about it. And in this video, I'll show you the new Instagram dimensions, exactly how to fix your covers that you've already posted, and design with Canva for this new Instagram feed correctly moving forward. Ready? Let's do this. First of all, I have to say this looks like a pretty controversial change. From what I've seen in conversations online, the creators on the app generally tend to embrace the change given that they've been posting in the portrait ratio for a long time anyway, and this new thumbnail view really makes it shine and come to life. On the other hand, we have everyday users who generally hate the idea, plus a lot of other creatives like photographers, for example, who have been gradually pushed out of the landscape format more and more, and also creators who curated square-based feeds for years, and this update ruins it all for them. And just like usual, despite the pleas from some groups, it looks like this change is permanent. Now, my two cents in here, although I've been posting in portrait ratio for a long time, and aesthetically, this new feed doesn't really affect me much, I don't really like how derivative it all is. I mean, let's be honest, it's another way in which Instagram wants to look like TikTok, and the fact that the platforms are doing so much in trying to parrot this TikTok experience feels so derivative, so boring, and way too cookie cutter for me. Now, my biggest concern here is the unnecessary extra work that comes with the actual dimension. So let me explain. So far, what the most recommended post format was in 4:5 ratio, which is 1080 pixels by 1350 pixels. The profile feed preview was a square of 1080 pixels per side, so we had to optimize for the middle portion, and that's it, we were sorted. Same goes for Reels and Reels covers. If we had a vertical video format, all we had to do when choosing or designing the cover was watching out for this middle portion of the post. Now, because the new preview is in 3:4 ratio, so 1015 by 1350 pixels, we have to take that extra thing into account. Granted, it's not that big because it's literally an extra margin of 32.5 pixels on each side, but it requires an extra layer of checks, which adds to the mental load for us creators. I mean, if we're changing the thumbnails preview to a portrait ratio too, why not just make it uniform, right? If anything, I'd like for Instagram to hear us out on this one at least. Oh, and we still have to optimize for the square preview like before, because one, there are still loads of people who see the old feed style, and two, because the whole explore page is still mostly a square format, so it's crucial to make sure your post can be viewed there perfectly. So in terms of dimensions, here's the cheat sheet, your guide to know what to do from now on, and I'm also giving you a template in the description box completely for free so that you know exactly what to do. But I'm not leaving you with just this, I have a very practical tip on what to do if your lovely aesthetic feed got messed up by the update. And let's also jump into Canva so that you can see how you can design properly and easily moving forward. But onto the tip first, go to your profile, press hold on the post thumbnail you want to tweak, and this pop-up will appear. Swipe to the bottom and you'll see the option to adjust the preview. When you tap it, not only does it give you the option to change the positioning of your cover, but you can also tap here to change it altogether. Now, the first option is great for those of you who just need a little tweak like I did, and the second is for those of you who are posting in a square format so far. Now, I appreciate it may be a lot of work if you have years worth of posts, but frankly, not many people actively browse the profile, so all you'd need to do is to just check the last 12 or maybe 24 and do it over time as well. Luckily, we also have guides in Canva that help you design for this new feed, so let's jump in. Let's start with a static post. As you can see, this one is in the portrait ratio, and I already see the guides because whenever I design, I always add them for myself just to make things a lot easier. Now, to enable guides, first what you need to do is to go here to File at the top, then go to Settings, and then Show Rulers and Guides. From here, you also can click Add Guides, but what I love to do is to just drag them from the side like this. Now, how do you make sure that you're getting the dimensions right? Well, I add the rectangle to the middle of my screen just like this. I'll just move it a little bit and I just drag it by the sides. of course, in position. Make sure that it's in the middle and in the center. And from here, by dragging it to the sides, I just attach it to the margins like this. And you can see in advance that this is the width and the height, which is exactly what we want to watch out for. Now, the next thing I do then is to drag the guides in here to position. And as you can see, the top one is at 135 pixels and the bottom one is at 1215 pixels. From here, you can just delete it. And this is what we would do before. So we only had to watch out for the middle section. However, right now we need to make sure that we've got this other bit in here as well. And this sits at 32.5 pixels. Now, what I like to do is to add another rectangle just like this, just to make things easier for me, and then drag it to the sides. You won't have these guides, so they won't snap to it. So let's say I want something a little bit like this, and then I go back to position, and from width in here, you can change it to 32.5. And this is how you see that this is the exact dimension that you need. And again, you can just drag it from the side like this and place it. It will show at 33, but if it snaps to the sides, it will be 32.5. And this is what you need to do on the other side as well. So what I would do from here is to just move this particular one to the side like this, and you will be able to snap another guide into place like this. But do you have to do it every single time? Yes, normally you would, but I do have a trick to make things easier for you. What I love to do is to just add another rectangle like this. I'm just going to duplicate it to the side and then add the one to the top. So I've got this one and I'll cover it completely just like this, snapping onto place. Just make sure that it fills the whole space just like that. And it should show you that it's 1080 by 135. And I'll just duplicate that one to the bottom as well. And now we have this lovely frame. But what I love to do is to actually go to the colors at the top and then to the color picker and actually choose the background color of Canva so that you can almost feel that it's disappearing. And I'll change that to for all the other ones as well. So in here and this one as well. And you can see now that even if I disabled the guides by holding shift and R, because you can just easily toggle them, this is how my preview looks, and it's super easy to see. Now, what you need to take into account now is that you are losing a bit of the side. So what I would always take into account when designing is to leave a little bit more margin on the sides that you maybe would normally. Now, all you need to do is to select these rectangles again, just like that, and copy them over to a blank page, just like this. And then if you go to download and download it as a PNG with transparent background, which granted is a Canva Pro only feature, but if you want to use the trial and maybe do that while you have the trial, you can just grab the link from the description box below. I will select the page just as the current page and download it. And what happens is that when you re-upload it back into Canva, I always have it in my uploads, and I actually go to any of my other designs. I can just quickly grab this preview like this and stretch it out, and this is how I always see what this will look like based on the specific preview. I also have the narrow sides just like this, and I can just stretch them out like that, and I can see how much of that post I'm missing from the sides now. Now let's jump into Instagram covers. In here, the situation is a little bit more complicated maybe because you've got more to look out for. So first, we're adding the guides on the side in the same exact vein as with the static post. So we need them at 32.5 pixels from each side. So this sits at 33 in here for me and 1047 from the right hand side. Again, just drag it and place it at this particular dimension. If you can see it, you can always just zoom in using your mouse to scroll in, and you will be able to be a lot more precise just like that. You can see that it can go kind of by pixel. You can see that in between somewhere is the half a pixel. I don't think you have to be that precise, but if you want to, just again, add those rectangles by specifying the pixels in the advanced settings. Now, apart from this, we need to look out for the portrait ratio now in here. So from the top, this is 285. So we're dragging and placing somewhere around here on a zoom, of course. And the bottom bit sits at 1,635 pixels. So this is what we need to look out for. And of course, still optimizing for the middle square, which is sitting at 1,500 from the bottom and 420 from the middle section. Again, this is how you can plan out your grid. And again, because I design all of my thumbnails like this, it's very easy for me because I can just jump in. And the same goes for doing those rectangular shapes for yourself. I've added this one for myself just to be able to see what the middle portion looks like. And voila, this is the preview. This is what it looks like without the guides and with the guides. So this is how we can easily check if none of the very important content gets cut off at any stage of our followers or any viewers previewing our posts, and they can easily see what the post is all about. And again, make sure to keep these in your upload files for very, very easy access like this. But that's not all. We have more changes coming. And this first one, I'm very sour about. Very soon, Instagram will remove the highlight bubbles that we all know and love from underneath your bio. Instead, they will now live under another tab like your posts and real feeds on the profile. Again, it's another way that Instagram is losing its identity by trying to mimic a competitor. And this, I believe, will also affect the experience of your potential and existing followers. Highlights are such an amazing way to showcase the most important things about you. As a creator, of course, but also just as a person, and super helpful and accessible as a consumer too. When they get stashed away under another tab, they will frankly cease to serve its purpose, and it's not a move in the right direction, I think. Stories and highlights are such a big part of Instagram, and to decenter them just makes no sense. Luckily, I do have some really good news to balance it all out. Masseri also announced we will be able to edit the grid, meaning we'll be able to reorder the post as we please, which is so, so cool. I'm sure you wanted to do this at least once before, and it's just like the grid planning features we get in apps like Later or Flick. On top of that, we'll also be able to post directly to our profile grid without this showing on our followers' post feeds. This one may not sound as exciting, but trust me, it really is. It can also be so helpful when you want to curate a few crucial posts to pin to the top, to highlight what you do, to create a reintroduction post, or maybe a start here one that your existing community doesn't really have to see again. This is a pretty powerful combo and will give us much more control, not just over the aesthetic, but also the overall feel and value of the profile as well. But I want to know how you feel about the new feed. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Let me know in the comments, and make sure you watch this video now too so that you can build a strong, solid strategy and take your content to the next level this year. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.